Hello, my name is Tatenda Chwanga and Dinwera Simboti. So today we're going to be talking about the equipment and the services that you need for you to start your gold mining venture. So in my last video, I spoke about the paperwork that you need for you to start your gold mining venture. So today we're going to be talking about the equipment that you may need to start. Right, so quick disclaimer before I start. In terms of equipment, we need to know that there's a vast list of equipment. We can spend days just talking about equipment. So I'm just going to give out a list that I feel is absolutely necessary for you to start mining and have a profitable gain from your mine. The first thing on my list is a compressor and a jackhammer. So this is the equipment that you're going to be using to drill into the rock. To buy this, a jackhammer and the compressor, it can get a bit expensive, right? But in my first venture, I hired. The second thing on my list is a water pump. So you're going to realize that when you start digging, when you go below a certain point, maybe about 20 meters deep, you will realize that you sort of like hit some kind of water catchment and water starts sipping down into your shaft, and you don't want that, so you need to pump the water outside. The third thing on my list is an electric generator, right? So this is what you're going to be using to power your pump, right? First, and your lighting. That so I will explain further a bit later about why I included lighting. The fourth thing on my list is what is known as a windlass. Right, so basically, some of you may know it as Windris. Right, you may need that, or you can get yourself a small headgear, right, and a winch. That's if you afford it, or if you can hire it, that's an option as well. So number five on my list is a truck that you need, right? So you don't need to actually purchase one because you're going to be using a truck to transport your ore to the grinding mill. So you could actually just hire it, and within the mining area that you're going to be working in, definitely, I know there will be someone who's got a truck. The sixth thing on my list is LED floodlights. So this is just in case you decide to do multiple shifts at your mine. So this includes maybe working at night, you may need have LED floodlights. LED floodlights are more energy efficient, so that depends if you're going to be using a generator, and you can actually use solar power because they work together quite well because of their efficiency, so that's something you may need to consider. Number seven is battery powered LED lamps, right? So these are the lamps that you're going to be putting in your shaft and in your tunnel. The reason why I go for battery powered is because I feel that it's a lot safer, because you don't want to be running down cables, right, into the mine filled with electricity in a moist place. If anything goes wrong, definitely someone might get fried, and we don't want that. So I feel like battery powered LED lamps are much safer. And lastly on my list, you're gonna have your picks, your shovels and your buckets, right? So if you just buy any regular bucket, it's probably not gonna work. What we did on my first mining venture was to buy 20 liter containers, right, then cut the bottom, right, so that you turn them upside down, and we made those into buckets because they are quite stronger and they would last a long time. Let's talk health and safety. So you will probably be required to timber your shafts and tunnels. So this basically is using timber poles, right, that are cut into maybe the length of your shafts, right, and they're going to be layered, right, on all the sides of the wall. Let's talk about protective gear. So this is your helmet, your work suit, your safety shoes, aka Indand, right? So all of this is just to protect your body, your employees as well, because a mine can be a dangerous place, and you are responsible for the safety of your workers. Right, so let's talk about the services that you need. Right, so firstly, you need to locate the nearest gold mills. It's going to be basically the place you're going to be taking your ore to get crushed and milled to extract your gold, right? And you are going to need to know the place where you buy your dynamites, because you don't want to be traveling a long distance to get your dynamites, right? So you need it to be somewhere local, and chances are there will be somewhere local where they sell dynamites. And then again, since we mentioned the jackhammer, right, so jackhammers have drill bits and they've got drill tips, right? So you need to know who reconditions those for you. So it has to be somewhere close as well if you are not willing to travel a lot, but that can be done anywhere else. But you need to know where you get those reconditioned, where you buy those, and where you get them serviced as well. And again, you have a compressor, you've got generators, all of these things use fuel, so you need to know where you are going to be sourcing that fuel. Something else that can be very, very helpful is to know the miners around your area. Try to sort of like build a network with the miners who are already in that area, because this will be very, very helpful. They've got a lot of knowledge of the area if they've been there for quite some time, and they will help you with the do's and don'ts, right, of that area. Because remember, you are going into a place that's got different, probably different tradition, different cultures and different beliefs to you, you know. And I remember when I started, a very big mistake I made was to let my beliefs known, and I was so open about them. There's, I guess if you're that person, it's all right, but it worked negatively towards my project. And for some reason, I offended certain people, a lot of potential to disrupt my business just by letting them know my beliefs, being open about them, speaking about them anytime. So it's something to be careful about. If you've got your beliefs, just keep them low, way low, like low. Because I had a big, big problem. Anyway, I hope you now know something you didn't. And if you found this video to be very helpful, please like and subscribe. And if you think that this video can help someone else, please feel free to share. And until next time, see you again.